His father's sisters.
我们一起来有一个祷告。
Let's pray together.
亲爱的天父，我们感谢赞美你的恩典。
Heavenly Father, we thank you for your grace.
主啊，是你亲自向我们启示你自己。
Because you revealed yourself to us.
以至于我们才能够来认识你。
So that we can know you.
才能够来敬拜你。
And worship you.
主啊，你是创造者。
Lord, you are the creator.
我们是受你所造的人。
We are the creatures.
天父，就恳求你帮助我们今天早晨能够安静我们的心。
Heavenly Father, help us to calm our heart tonight, this morning.
也存谦卑的心。
And give us a humble heart.
来到你面前。
So that we can come before you.
来聆听你的话语。
And to listen to your word.
来接受你的启示。
And receive your revelation.
以至于我们可以按照你的心意来敬拜。
So that we can worship you in your own will.
恳求你亲自的与我们同在。
We ask you to be with us.
祷告奉主耶稣基督名求。
In the name of Jesus Christ we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
在几年前我去到这个四川的青城山。
Several years ago, I went to 青城山。青城山 a place in 四川。
Yeah. 在那里看到了很多建造一半的偶像。
I saw a lot of halfway done idols.
有的是女的，有的是男的。
Some are male, some are female.
有的带着孩子，有的带着武器。
Some have weapons with them, some have children around.
我就问工人说，这些偶像是神吗？
So I asked the man, what are these idols?
还是木头？
Are they wood?
因为他们都是半成品。
Because they are half products.
他们都是一个一个人形的木头。
They all look like people, but they're woods.
没有颜色，没有上颜色，也没有细节。
There is no color, no details.
人们常常寻找一些事物来敬拜。
So people are looking for things to worship.
但是没有启示，人们就只能够按照他们的内心的意念来敬拜。
But without revelation, they can only worship according to their own desire.
按照他们的想象来敬拜。
According to their own imagination.
但是我们所信的上帝却不是如此。
But the God that we believe is not like this.
他是活的上帝。
He's a living God.
他亲自临到我们当中。
He came down to us.
他是永恒的上帝，不依靠人的雕刻。
He's the eternal God. He does not rely on the human the carvings of human being.
他也是救我们的上帝。
He's God who saved us.
所以我们就跟随他，向他祷告。
So that we can follow him and.Pray to him.
我们也敬拜他。
And worship him.
今天我们要来谈论的一个故事是在摩西和上帝之间。
Today we are going to talk about the stories between Moses and God.
当摩西出生的时候，新的法老已经登基了。
When Moses was born, the new Pharaoh was enthroned.
他不知道以色列人的祖先是谁。
He did not know who are the ancestors of Israelites.
不认识雅各，也不认识约瑟。
He did not know Jacob, neither Joseph.
他是埃及的王。
He is the king of Egypt.
他根据自己的种族身份来管理埃及地。
He ruled the land of Egypt according to his own ethnic identity.
所以当他看到以色列人越来越强壮的时候，
So when he saw Israelites become stronger and stronger,
他就计划灭绝这个民族。
He planned to exterminate them.
所以他杀了所有的婴儿。
So he killed all the infants.
虐待以色列人，并且奴役他们。
And abused Israelites and enslaved them.
当摩西出生的时候，他的妈妈就把他藏了三个月。
When Moses was born, his mom hid him for 3 months.
但是最后藏不住了，就把他放在河里。
When she was no longer able to hide him, he put him on the river.
接着摩西就被法老的女儿收养。
Then Moses was adopted by Pharaoh's daughter.
他成了王子，住在王宫里。
So he became prince and lived in the palace.
接受埃及最好的教育。
So he accepted the best education in Egypt.
他很优秀，和其他的埃及的男孩一样，有自己的梦想。
So he was excellent, and he also had the same dream, had the dream as other Egyptian boys.
他知道自己是特别的，知道自己是希伯来人。
Also, he knew he was special because he knew he was Hebrew.
所以有一天，当他看见一个埃及人打一个希伯来人的时候
，So one day when he saw an Egyptian beating a Hebrew，
他左右观看见没有人，就把那个埃
So he looked around, see there were nobody seen, so he killed that Egyptian.
这样他就从一个王子成了一个杀人犯。
So from he became a fugitive murderer from the prince.
从王宫就逃到了旷野。
He escaped from palace to the wilderness.
就在一天的时间里面，他所有的英雄梦都破灭。
So his heroic dreams disappeared in one day.
他逃到旷野的时候40岁。
So he was 40 years old when he escaped. He fled to the wilderness.
就在那里牧羊40年。
And he herding the sheep for 40 years.
他的生计依然依靠着岳父来活的。
Actually, his life was supported by his father-in-law.
看起来他的这个生活也十分的惬意。
So his life seemed comfortable.
他很显然已经不打算再回埃及去了。
He seemed like he had no plan to return to Egypt.
但随着上帝的计划进入到下一个阶段。
But God's plan entered to the next stage.
摩西的生命就再次发生了改变。
So Moses' life changed again.
出埃及记第三章就从这里开始。
So this is where the Exodus chapter 3 starts.
有一天摩西看见了燃烧的荆棘。
One day Moses saw a burning bush.
但是荆棘却没有被烧毁。
But the bush was not burned up.
摩西说我要去看看这个大异象。
So Moses wanted to see the big vision.
这个荆棘为什么没有烧坏呢？
Why the bush is not burning up?
正在这个时候上帝就呼叫摩西。
At this time God called Moses.
说摩西你不要近前来。
He said, do not come any near.
要把你脚上的鞋脱下来，因为你所站的是圣地。
You need to take off your sandals because you are standing on the holy ground.
接着上帝就命令摩西去到以色列人当中。
So God commanded Moses to return to the Israelites.
告诉他们以色列的神要拯救他们。
Telling him that the God of Israel will save them.
如果你有圣经，我们就一起翻开圣经到出埃及记的三章十二到二十二节。
Okay, if you have Bible with you, please turn to Exodus chapter 3, verses 12 to 22.
我把这一段的经文一共分成三段。
I divided this passage into three parts.
12到15节。
Verses 12 through 15 is part
1. 15到17节。
And 15 to 17.
18到22节。
And verses 18 to 22.
最后我们会回到十二节。
Lastly, we will return to verse 12.
我们今天讲到的主题是按照上帝的所示来敬拜他。
The theme of today's sermon is worship God according to who He is.
按照上帝的所示敬拜他。
Worship God according to who He is.
第一点，我们要看第十二到第十五节。
First, let's look at verses 12 through 15.
敬拜神，因为他是至高的。
We worship God because He is the Most High.
敬拜神，因为他是至高的。
Yeah, worship God because He is the Most High.
在创世纪的在出埃及记三章十二到十五节这样说：神说，我必与你同在，你将百姓从埃及地领出来之后，你们必在这山上侍奉我，这是我打发你去的证据。摩西说，对神说，我到以色列人那里对他们说，你们祖宗的神打发我到你们这里来。他们若问我说，他叫什么名字，我要对他们说什么呢？神对摩西说，我是自有拥有的。又说，你要对以色列人这样说，那自有的打发我到你们这里来。神又对摩西说，你要对以色列人这样说，耶和华你们祖宗的神，就是亚伯拉罕的神，以撒的神，雅各的神，打发我到你们这里来，耶和华是我的名，直到永远，这也是我的纪念，直到万代。
Okay, let's read in English, verses 12 through 15. He said, but I will be with you, and this shall be the sign for you, that I have sent you when you have brought the people out of Egypt. You shall serve God on this mountain.Then Moses said to God, if I come to the people of Israel and say to them, the God of your fathers have sent me to you, and they ask me, what is his name? What shall I say to them? God said to Moses, I am who I am. And he said, say this to the people of Israel, I am has sent me to you. God also said to Moses, say this to the people of Israel, the Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob has sent me to you. This is my name forever, and thus I am to be remembered throughout all generations.
所以在这个部分里面，摩西问上帝，你的名字是什么？
Here Moses asked God, what is your name?
他不是问你是谁。
He didn't ask who you are.
而是问你的名字是什么。
But rather ask, what is your name?
你叫什么名字？
What's your name?
我们敬拜神是根据神的身份。
So we worship God according to his identity.
是根据神他的所事。
And according to who he is.
也就是说，因为神是神，所以我们敬拜他。
Yeah, this is saying that because God is God, that's why we worship him.
但是我们怎么描述他的身份呢？
So how can we describe his identity?
这是一个很困难的问题。
This is a very difficult.
事实上，所有的语言都是上帝创造的。
Because all the languages were created by God.
所以一个受造物要怎么用一个受造的方式去描述一位创造者？
So how can a creature describe a creator in a created way?
受造物怎么样命名创造者？
How does the creation name the creator?
这是很奇怪的。
So this is very strange.
或者我们可以说这几乎是不可能的。
So this is nearly impossible.
这就好像两台计算机。
This is like two computers.
他们之间在发生的主动性的思考和对话。
So they are...Thinking and conversation, having conversation.
但是两台计算机之间之所以能够对话，
they can talk to each other.
这个都是人类通过特别的方法来设计。
This is because they were designed by God, by people.
所以人类不仅为计算机创造了语言。
So people not only created language for computers.
他们还为他们创造了对话的功能。
They also created the function that they can talk to each other.
然后现在这两台计算机要怎么描述人类呢？
So how could these two computers describe people?
就是那个创造我们的那个。
Maybe they can only say the one who created us.
所以这里摩西问上帝，你的名字是什么？
So here Moses asked God, what is your name?
就制造了这样一个类似的画面。
So this is the similar picture.
如果不是上帝亲自告诉人类他是谁，
If God did not tell people who he is,
他叫什么名字，
What his name is,
人类就永远无法知道他是谁，他叫什么。
People would never know who he is and what his name is.
事实上他们应该还记得他，记得上帝的名字。
Say it again, sorry.
事实上他这个以色列人应该还记得上帝的名字。
Actually, the Israelites should have remembered God's name.
摩西和以色列人知道上帝的名字。
Moses and Israelites actually knew God's name.
在创世纪，上帝就已经用不同的名字来启示他自己。
In the book of Genesis, God revealed his name in different ways.
比如说在创世纪第十七章。
Such as in chapter 17, in Genesis.
上帝说我是全能的神。
God said, I'm the God Almighty.
希伯来语是 El Shaddai.
In Hebrews, it's El Shaddai.
就是全能的神的意思。
It means God Almighty.
这个名字同样出现在创世纪的其他部分。
This name also appeared in other parts of the book, in the book of Genesis.
在创世纪的二十八章。
In Genesis chapter 28,
以撒给雅各祝福的时候。
When Isaac blessed Jacob,
他也说愿全能的神赐福给你，使你生养众多。
He also said,The God Almighty bless you and make you fruitful and multiply.
在创世纪四十三章十四节。
In Genesis 43, chapter 43, verse 14.
雅各在祝福他孩子的时候。
When Jacob blessed his children.
也说愿全能的神使你们在那人面前蒙恩惠。
He also said that may God Almighty grant you mercy before that man.
所以你可以看到全能的神这个名字是从亚伯拉罕到以撒。到雅各，一直到雅各的孩子。
So this God Almighty, this name actually passed down through Abraham, Jacob, and his children.
所以摩西和以色列人应该是知道上帝的名字的。
So Moses and the Israelites, they should know the name of God.
El Shaddai, 全能的神。
The name El Shaddai, God Almighty.
就是他的名字。
This is his name.
但是为什么摩西要问上帝你叫什么名字呢？
Then why Moses still ask what is your name?
所以有的学者就指出说，这里应该他们以色列人如果会问这个问题，应该不是因为他们无知。
So many scholars pointed out that this is not because they are innocent.
有可能他们是要故意刁难摩西的这个传统文化知识够不够硬。
So actually they are trying to intentionally create difficulties for Moses to test him his history classes.
意思就是在问，是在什么样的心灵之下上帝向你显现的呢？
Actually,The question is, in what new name that God revealed to you?
或者是问你从上帝那里又领受了什么新的启示呢？
Or he was asked, actually, what new revelation you have received from God?
但是无论如何，接下来我们要思考上帝这个简短的答案。
So, well, we need to think about the short answer from God.
我是自由拥有。
I am who I am.
在 ESV 里面是我I am who I am.
Yeah, ESV versions translate to I am who I am.
但是在 NIV 里面是 I will be what I will be.
Oh, the NIV translation is I will be what I will be.
所以自由拥有这个词已经成为一个中文的神学名词。
So this word I am who I am has become a theological term in Chinese.
对，这个词就是自由拥有。这是一个中文加上的意义。
So the meaning was added in Chinese translation.
原文的圣经翻译出来就是我是那个我是。
The original language is simply I am who I am.
或者你可以理解为我是我是。
Or I am I am.
但是这是什么意思呢？
So what does this mean?
很直面的理解就是这是一个根源性的问题。
The simple understanding is that this is an issue of origin, of source.
再往前就没有答案。
There is no answer if you dig deeper.
举一个例子来说。
Give you an example.
当我们说一杯水是由水分子组成的时候。
When we say a cup of water, it consists of water molecules.
水分子又是由两个氢原子和一个氧原子组成。
And the water molecule consists of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen.
然后氢原子又是由什么组成的呢？
What does hydrogen atom consist of?
是由一个正价的质子和一个负价的电子组成的。
It consists of a negative electron and a positive proton.
那它们又是由什么组成的呢？
What are they composed of?
没有了。
Nothing can find.
质子就是质子。
The proton is the proton.
电子就是电子。
An electron is electron.
所以我们说这个问题走到头了。
So this question come to an end.
因为不能够再拆分了。
Because we can not divide anymore.
这句话听起来好像没有回答这个问题。
It seems like this did not answer the question.
但这句话又已经真正回答了这个问题。
Actually, it answered the question.
我们再来换另外一个例子。
Another example.
就当我们说摩西是从哪里来的呢？
So when we ask where Moses is from,
我们会说摩西是从雅各来的。
Oh, when we say Moses was a descendant of Jacob.
雅各是从以撒来的。
Jacob was from Isaac.
以撒是从亚伯拉罕来的。
And Isaac, Abraham.
亚伯拉罕是从挪亚来的。
Abraham, Noah.
挪亚是从亚当来的。
And Noah, Adam.
但是亚当呢？
How about Adam?
没了。
There's no ancestor.
亚当就是亚当。
Adam is Adam.
亚当不是从谁生出来的。
Whom Adam was from?
亚当是被造的。
Adam was not from born of anybody, but rather he was created.
所以在这个问题上，亚当就是亚当。
So in this question, Adam is Adam.
这句话听起来好像没有回答这个问题。
Seems like it did not answer the question.
但这句话却又已经真正回答了这个问题。
Actually, it answered the question.
好，我们现在回到这句经文里面。
So let's return to this verse.
当上帝说我是的时候
，When God said I am who I am，
是什么意思呢
？What does this mean？
意思就是说我就是我。
Which means I am, I am.
我的存在就是我的存在。
My existence is my existence.
我就是本源。
I'm the source.
我就是最终极的那一位。
I'm the ultimate one.
在我之前没有任何存在的。
There's nothing existed before me.
在我之上没有任何存在的。
There's nothing above me.
在我之外没有任何存在的。
There's nothing outside me.
我就是一切，我就是万有。
All, I'm all and I'm everything.
万有都在我以下。
Everything is under me.
万有都在我里面。
And everything is in me.
万有都是从我而出。
And everything is from me.
这个世界上的语言不能够描述我。
The languages, in this world cannot describe me.
所有的语言都是在我以后是我创造的。
Because all the languages were created by me.
天地万物还没有的时候就有了我。
Before the heavens and earth, there were me.
而有一天，天地万物都过去了，我仍然永远存在。
And one day the heavens and earth will pass away, but I will still exist.
这个不是很好理解。
So this is hard to understand.
但是我想，我们最重要要明白的就是。
So the most important thing is that we need to understand.
上帝是那个本源。
And God is His own source.
是我们无法描述的本源。
And he is the source that we cannot describe.
是一切的本源。
And he is the source of everything.
我们作为他所造的人。
As the creation of him.
没有办法描述他。
We cannot describe him.
我们和他之间是不平等的。
So there is no equality between us and him.
我们和他之间也不是上下级。
And we are not like boss and servant relationship.
我们和他是两个部分。
So we are totally different, two different categories.
是创造者和受造者的关系。
The relationship, it's a relationship between creation and creator.
不是泥土匠和泥土匠徒弟的关系。
Not the relationship between the potter and the intern potter.
也不是泥土匠和泥土匠仆人的关系。
And not the relationship between the potter and the servant of the potter.
而是泥土匠和陶器的关系。
It's a relationship between the potter and the pot.
我们是他造的。
So we are his creation.
接下来到了第十五节。
Verse 15.
上帝进一步展开他的解释。
God expounded his answer.
说耶和华你们祖宗的神，耶和华是我的名。
He said, I'm the God of your fathers, and Jehovah is my name.
在这里很清晰的，上帝启示他的名是耶和华。
Here clearly God revealed his name, Jehovah.
在英文圣经里面，所有的这个大写的 L-O-R-D.
So in the English translation, all the words in capital L-O-R-D.
在中文的圣经里面就是翻译成耶和华。
The Chinese translation is 耶和华。
耶和华是一个音译，是从 Jehovah 音译过来的。
Yeah, it's translated according to the pronunciation Jehovah.
Jehovah 又是从希伯来语中的亚位音译过来的。
And Jehovah was translated from the Hebrew language Yahweh.
事实上，我们已经不知道这个最准确的发音是什么了。
Actually, we don't know the exact pronunciation.
我们只知道声母，不知道韵母。
We only know the consonants.But we do not know the vowels.
因为记载下来的只有声母。
Because only the consonants were recorded.
这个声母如果用英文字母来表示的话，就是 YHWH.
In English, it is expressed as YHWH.
每次当犹太人看到希伯来语里面有这个 YHWH 这个发音的这个字母的时候，真的是那个希伯来语的字母，他们就会用 Adonai 来替换。
So when Hebrews, when they saw these letters, they would use another expression Adonai.
所以呢，这个 Adonai 里面的 ROI 这三个韵母。
So these three letters ROI, three vowels.
配上 YHW 这三个声母。
When it combines with this consonant YHW,
当它一结合就变成了 Jehovah 这个英文。
So when it combined together, it becomes the English name Jehovah.
然后译成中文就是耶和华。
So it translated into Chinese as 耶和华。
所以结论就是耶和华就是亚威。
So the conclusion is that Jehovah is Yahweh.
就是那个古老的希伯来圣经上所启示的上帝的名字。
This is the God's name revealed in ancient Hebrew scripture.
上帝在这里说，我是自由拥有的，我是亚威。
So God here says, I am who I am, I'm Yahweh.
这是一个宣告。
This is a declaration.
宣告上帝是任何事物、语言都不能够描述的。
This declaration is that God cannot be described by anything in any language.
这个世界和其上的受造物都不能承担我的名字。
And nothing on this world can bear my name.
因为我是起名字的那个人，而不是接受名字的。
Because I'm the one who gave the name, not the one who received the name.
我有终极的权柄。
So I have the ultimate authority.
在这个宇宙当中，没有任何的权柄高过我。
So nothing in this universe has authority over me.
接下来我们要看到第二点。
Second,
是从第十五节到第十七节。
From verses 15 to 17.
敬拜神，因为他是活的，并且是信实的。
Worship God for He is faithful and living.
敬拜神，因为他是活的，并且是信实的。
We worship God because He is living and faithful.
从第十五节开始，神又对摩西说：“你要对以色列人这样说：耶和华你们祖宗的神，就是亚伯拉罕的神、以撒的神、雅各的神，打发我到你们这里来。耶和华是我的名，直到永远，这也是我的纪念，直到万代。”
Verse 15, God also said to Moses, Say this to the people of Israel, The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob, has sent me to you. This is my name forever, and thus I am to be remembered throughout all generations.
16到17节，你去召聚以色列的长老，对他们说，耶和华你们祖宗的神，就是亚伯拉罕的神、以撒的神、雅各的神，向我显现，说，我实在眷顾了你们，我也看见埃及人怎样待你们，我也说要将你们从埃及的困苦中领出来，往迦南人、赫人、亚摩利人、比利洗人、希未人、耶布斯人的地区，就是到牛奶与蜜之地。
Okay, verse 16 to 17. Go and gather the elders of Israel together and say to them, The Lord, the God of your fathers, the God of Abraham, of Isaac, and of Jacob, has appeared to me.Saying, I have observed you and what has been done to you in Egypt. And verse 17. And I promise that I will bring you up out of the affliction of Egypt to the land of, now here are difficult, Canaanites, Hittites, Amorites, and Perizzites, and Hivites, and Jebusites, a land flowing with milk and honey.
在这里我们首先要看到的第一点是上帝是活的。
First, we need to know that God is living.
在这里上帝是一个字一个字的教摩西说话和做事。
Because here, God teaches Moses word by word how he should say and do things.
所以在这里首先我想要强调的是一系列的动词。
So we need to look at all a series of verbs.
在这里有说、打发我、眷顾了你们、向我显现、看见了、我也说、我也领出来。
All these verbs include say, has sent, and to be remembered, appeared, observed, promise, and bring you up.
在这里有一系列的动词。
So here are a series of verbs.
动词说明了什么？
What does the verbs say?
动词说明需要有一个主语。
The verb means you need a subject.
而且这个主语要有主观的主动性。
And the subject need to be active.
这个主语需要有意识。
And the subject should have conscience.
这个主语是活的。
And the subject should be alive.
所以上帝是活的。
So that God is living.
他是又真又活的神。
He is living God.
这真是一个令我们兴奋的消息。
So this is exciting news for us.
上帝在乎他的百姓。
And because God cared about His people,
他向他们说话。
He spoke to them,
他向他们显现。
And appeared to them,
他派使者给他们。
And also sent his angels to them.
他眷顾他们，也看见了他们。
So he cared about them, and he also saw them.
并且他应许了他们。
And gave them promise.
应许了什么呢？
What did he promise?
应许了他要拯救他。
God promised that he would save them.
对于以色列人而言，这是一个多么令人惊讶、震惊而且惊喜的消息。
For people of Israel, this is a wonderful, shocking, and joyful news.
所以那位至高的称为我是的，那位自有拥有的那位上帝。
Because that Most High called himself I am who I am.
而且他是自有拥有的，对的上帝，他看见了我，眷顾了我。
This God saw me and remembered me.
他向我说话，他要拯救我。
And he spoke to me, and he will save me.
你想一想以色列人当时的感受。
Think about the feeling of the Israelites.
这位上帝是真的，是活的上帝。
This God is true and living.
不是死的，也不是睡觉的。
He is not sleeping. He is not dead.
不是木头，也不是金像。
He's not wood, neither gold.
也不是一个童话。
He's not a fairy tale.
他是真的，他就是他。
And he is true. He is who he is.
第二，上帝是信实的。
Secondly, God is faithful.
上帝没有忘记他们。
God did not forget them.
他纪念他们。
He remembered them.
400年过去了，他仍然纪念他们。
After 400 years, God still remembered them.
他能够拯救，也愿意拯救他们。
He was able to save them, and he was willing to save them.
这就是我第二点要强调的，上帝是信实的。
So this is why I emphasize that God is faithful.
上帝说他是耶和华，你们祖宗的神，就是亚伯拉罕、以撒、雅各的神。
God said he is Jehovah, your father's God, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Jacob.
他说耶和华是我的名，直到永远，这也是我的纪念，直到万代。
He said, Jehovah is my name, and this will be from generations to generation.
他是在说我是一位前后一致的神。
He was saying that I'm a consistent God from beginning to the end.
他在说昨天、今天一直到永远，我是不改变的那一位。
He was saying that from yesterday, today, and tomorrow, I'm the one who never changed.
他在说过去我怎么应许你们的祖先，今天我也要怎么应许你们。
He was saying that what I promised to your ancestors in the past, I will do the same to you.
过去我给我的祖先展现了什么样的慈爱、怜悯和恩典，今天我也要同样展现给你们。
The love, the compassion, and the grace that I showed to your ancestors, I will do it to you today as well.
他在说，今天和你们说话的这一位神是超越时间限制的。
The God who speaks to you transcends time.
他怎么样和你们的列祖说话，今天也要怎么样和你们说话。
So the way he spoke to your fathers, he will spoke to you today. Speak to you today.
他在说我是信实的守约的神。
He said, I'm the faithful and promise-keeping God.
那么上帝对于以色列人的列祖说了些什么呢？
What did he say to the ancestors or fathers of Israel people?
在创世纪第十五章的十三到十四节。
In Genesis chapter 15, verses 12 to 16.
对，十三到十四节。
Verse 13 to 15。
耶和华对亚伯兰说：“你要的确知道，你的后裔必寄居别人的地，又服侍那地的人。那地的人要苦待他们四百年，并且他们所要服侍的那国，我要惩罚。后来他们必带着许多财物从那里出来。”
Okay, Lord said to Abraham, Know for certain that your offspring will be sojourners in a land that is not theirs, and will be servants there. And they will be afflicted for 400 years, but I will bring judgment on the nation that they serve, and afterward they shall come out with great possessions.
所以现在上帝就在应成就他的预言。
Now God is fulfilling his promise.
四百年过去了，上帝的日子近了。
And because 400 years has passed, God's time is here.
第十六和十七节的话语包含了两个部分。
So the verses 16 to 17, consists two parts.
这两部分一起向我们显示上帝是一位信实守约的上帝。
And they show that God is a faithful and promise-keeping God.
前半部分宣告了他纪念过去和以色列人列祖所立的约。
The first part declared that he remembered the promise that he made with their ancestors.
第十七节启示了他接下来要怎么做。
And verse 7 revealed what he would do next.
他立约，他成就。
So he made the covenant and he fulfilled the covenant.
接下来我们要进入到第三点，是18到22节。
Next, let's look at verses 18 to 22.
敬拜神，因他是我们的拯救。
Worship God, for he is our salvation.
敬拜神，因他是我们的拯救。
Worship God, for he is our salvation.
我们一起读来看这个18到22节。他们必听你的话，你和以色列的长老要去见埃及王，对他说，耶和华希伯来人的神遇见了我们，现在求你容我们往旷野去，走三天的路程，为要祭祀耶和华我们的神。我知道虽用大能的手，埃及王也不容你们去。我必伸手在埃及中间施行我一切奇妙的事，又攻击那地，然后他才容你们去。我必叫你们在埃及人眼前蒙恩，你们去的时候就不至于空手而去。但各妇女要向她的邻舍，并居住在她家里的女人，要金器、银器和衣裳，好给你们的儿女穿戴。这样你们就把埃及人的财物夺去了。
Okay, here verses 18 through 22. And they will listen to your voice, and you and the elders of Israel shall go to the king of Egypt and say to him, The Lord, the God of Hebrews.Has met with us, and now please let us go a 3 days journey into the wilderness that we may sacrifice to the Lord our God. But I know that the king of Egypt will not let you go unless compelled by a mighty hand. So I will stretch out my hand and strike Egypt with all the wonders that I will do in it. After that, he will let you go.Go, and I will give these people favor in the sight of Egyptians. And when you go, you shall not go empty, but each woman shall ask for her neighbor, and any woman who lives in her house for silver and gold jewelry and for clothing, you shall put them on your sons and on your daughters. So you shall plunder the Egyptians.
在这里我要带大家先看到第十九节这个词，大能的手。
Well, in verse 19, there is a phrase that says "mighty hand."
在这里 ，ESV 用了 "unless" 这个词。
ESV used "unless" to translate.
除非用大能的手，否则法老王是不会让你们走的。
Unless the mighty hand, Pharaoh will not let you go.
在这里，上帝知道。让以色列人走的办法只有一个。
So God here mentioned that there's only one way to let Israelites go.
就是用大能的手。
That is His mighty hand.
他知道万事。
Because He knows everything.
他超越时间，所以他知道未来。
Because He transcends time, so He knows the future.
他知道将会发生什么。
He knows what will happen.
他知道法老不会让他们走。
And He knew that Pharaoh would not let them go.
但他不仅仅知道问题，他还知道如何解决问题。
Not only that he knew the problems, he also knows the ways to solve the problem.
这个解决的方案就是大能的手。
So the answer is, the solution is the mighty hand.
所以接着第二十节就说我必伸手。
So in verse 20, it says, I will stretch out my hand.
上帝在上一节说，我知道解决方法是大能的手。
Because in the previous verse, God says, I know the solution is the mighty hand.
在这一节就是我必伸手。
And this verse says that I will stretch out my hand.
这是什么意思呢？
So what does this mean?
意思就是说我的手够大能。
This means that my hand is mighty.
我的手就是大能的手。
My hand is the mighty hand.
我前面跟你们说了大能的手，其实是在说我的手。
Actually, I talked about the mighty hand, it is my hand.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹
So brothers and sisters,
没有其他的手，唯有上帝大能的手。
There is no other hand but God's mighty hand
才能够施行拯救
that can save us.
所以上帝把这个解决方案指向了他自己。
So God pointed the solution to himself.
上帝带着一种绝对的权柄来说话。
So God spoke in an absolute authority.
他不含糊其辞的。
There's no any blurred area.
他说话又清晰又确定。
And his word was firm and clear.
上帝不是让摩西去和法老谈判。
God did not ask Moses to negotiate with Pharaoh.
说法老啊，请你放我们走吧。
Asking Pharaoh, please let us go.
但是有两个解决方案。
There are two ways.
要谈大门敞开，要打奉陪到底。
If you open the door, let us go, or we can fight with you until the end.
或者说法老啊，请你放我们走。
Or they may say, Pharaoh, let us go.
但是如果你不放我们走，我们不排除使用武力。
If you don't let us go, we will not eliminate the possibility of using force.
不是的，上帝不是这么说的。
God did not say this.
他不需要玩文字游戏。
He did not to play the word.
他也不需要遮遮掩掩。
He did not have to hide.
打不过才要这样嘛，对吗？
If you cannot beat the enemy, you probably do this.
上帝不是这样，他是确定的，是清晰的。
But God is certain. God is not like that.
他是大能的，他有大能的手。
Because He is Almighty, He has the mighty hand.
他是绝对至高的，他知道事情会怎么发展。
He is the Most High, and He knows how the things will develop.
他也是绝对的胜利。
And He is victorious.
他有绝对的能力，他永不失败。
So He has the absolute power, and He never fails.
所以我们能够发现救赎。不仅仅是从某个环境中出来。
So we know that salvation is not coming out of something.
并且是到某个环境中去。
But also enter into something.
不仅仅是从某个环境中出来，并且要到某个环境中去，这才是救赎。
Not only out, but also into. This is salvation.
在这里就圣经就向我们展现了救赎的终点。
So the Bible shows us the finish point of salvation.
就是那位自有拥有的神，现在要领以色列人进入到应许之地去。
The God, I am who I am, will lead Israelites into the promised land.
他不仅领他们出来，他们还要领他进去。
Not only that they take them out, He took them out, but also lead them into.
这才是一个完整的救赎。
So this is the complete salvation.
当上帝拯救他的百姓脱离奴役的枷锁的时候
，When God saved their people out of the bondage of slave，
他没有把他们领出来就完了
，He didn't stop there and just take them out，
而是领出来又领进那个牛奶与蜜之地
，And also He led them into the land flowing with milk and honey。
这是上帝的救赎。
So this is the salvation of God。
所以我们现在回到第十二节。
So let's return to verse 12.
所以当我们读这个十三到二十二节这么长的内容的时候
，So after we have read the verses 12 to 22, a long passage.
这么长的内容是为了什么呢
？What is the
为了什么目的呢
purpose? What the purpose?
是为了第十二节。
Actually, the purpose is to explain verse 12.
第十二节说。我必与你同在，你将百姓从埃及领出来之后，你们必在这山上侍奉我，这是我打发你去的证据。
So verse 12 said, He said, But I will be with you, and this shall be the sign for you, that I have sent you. When you have brought the people out of Egypt, you shall serve God on this mountain.
所以上帝差遣摩西去找以色列人。
So God sent Moses to find Israelites,
启示他自己是谁。
Revealed who he is,
并且说我之前，我纪念之前和你们列祖所立的约。
And told them that I remember the promise that I made with your fathers.
就是为了使你们在这山上侍奉我。
For the purpose that you can serve me on this mountain.
就是要为了使你们在这山上敬拜我。
So that you can worship me on this mountain.
所以我们看到一个很清楚的逻辑在这里。
So this is a clear logic here.
是上帝先启示他自己
，and God revealed Himself first，
先告诉人类他是谁
，and tell people who He is，
人类才有可能敬拜他
Then people can worship him.
才有可能认识他。
And then people can know him.
我们敬拜上帝是按照上帝的所事来敬拜他。
So we worship God according to who he is.
而他自己的身份是他自己告诉我们的。
His identity is revealed to us by himself.
否则我们无法知道。
Otherwise we could not know anything.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹。
So brothers and sisters.
当我们在读以色列人故事的时候。
So when we read the stories about Israelites.
我们要明白那一位拯救以色列人出埃及的神。
So we need to declare that the one who saved Israelites out of Egypt.
也是今天拯救我们脱离罪的奴役的神。
He is also the God today who saved us from the bondage of sin.
我们信靠耶稣基督蒙他的拯救。
So when we trust in Jesus, we are saved.
我们要知道耶稣基督就是那一位我是。
We need to know that Jesus Christ is that I am.
耶稣基督就是那位信实且永活的神。
He is the faithful and the living God.
他用他大能的双手领我们出黑暗进入奇妙光明的美德。
He used his mighty hands to lead us out of darkness and into the light.
他是那位领我们出死入生的主。
He is the Lord who has passed, let us pass from death to life.
当你明白我是的含义之后，你是否对于我是有一个全面的认识？
After you have understood the word I am, do you have a comprehensive understanding about this word I am?
带着这个背景，当你读到新约约翰福音八章。
With this background, when you read the New Testament, like John chapter 8,
58节的时候,
verse 58,
你就能够明白耶稣在说什么。
You would understand what Jesus was saying.
约翰福音八章五十八节，耶稣说：“我实实在在的告诉你们，在亚伯拉罕出生以前，我就已经存在。”
John 8:58, Jesus said to them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, before Abraham was, I am."
原文和英文都是在亚伯拉罕以前我是。
The original language and the English translation was Before Abraham, I was, I am.
耶稣用了一个和出埃及记三章十四节一模一样的短语，就是我是。
So Jesus said the same word, I am, as in Exodus chapter 3, verse 14.
这真是一个令人震惊的时刻。
So this is a shocking moment.
另外一个例子出现在马可福音六章。
Another example appeared in Mark chapter 6.
六章四十五到五十二节。
Chapter 6, 45 to 52 verses.
这里的中文就很好理解。
Here the Chinese is easy to understand.
当门徒们在海面遇到风浪快要沉下去的时候。
When the disciples was on the sea and encountered a storm, the boat was sinking.
耶稣在海面上行走。
Jesus was walking on the sea.
然后靠近他们说，是我，不要怕。
And Jesus approached them and said, I am, don't be afraid.
原文也是我是，在希腊文里面。
And in the original language, Greek also, it also means I am.
为什么是他就不要怕？
Why we don't have to be afraid if it was him?
因为生活在那个时代的门徒明白。
Because the disciples who lived in that age understood.
这句话是什么意思？
Understood the meaning of this sentence.
这句话不仅仅是一个今天一个简单的是我。
It's not like it's me, like today's language.
这是一个永恒的宣告。
This is an eternal declaration.
耶稣在使用一个在那个文化里面被绝对神圣化的一个短语。
So he was using a phrase that was absolutely sacred in their culture.
那个文化，对。这个短语叫做我是。
This phrase is I am.
所以当约翰福音里面耶稣一讲我是的时候。
So when Jesus said I am in the Gospel of John.
在八章五十九节他们就拿石头要打他。
And in John chapter 8:59, it recorded that they want to stone him to death.
为什么呢？因为就算他比亚伯拉罕老又怎么样？
Because they thought even he was older than Abraham, and so what?
顶多他是一个疯子，风言风语，不理他就是了。
At most, he's a lunatic crazy talk, maybe just ignore him.
为什么要拿石头打死他？
Why they would stone him to death?
因为他们认为他在亵渎上帝。
Because they thought he was blaspheming to God.
可是耶稣就是宣告他就是神。
But Jesus declaring that he is God.
今天的人听到耶稣是什么反应？
So what reactions we have today when we heard about Jesus?
你听见耶稣这样的宣告，你是什么反应？
When Jesus declared like this, what are your reactions?
你是生气还是愤怒？
You will become angry?
还是不屑一顾，觉得这个不值一提呢？
Or you just shrug off and maybe not even worthy mention it?
还是你敬拜他？
Or you worship him?
所以我想要引用C.S. 刘易斯的一段话。
I want to use the saying of C.S. Lewis.
他这样说。
This is how he says.
我现在想阻止任何人说人们常说的那些极其愚蠢的话。我准备接受耶稣是一个伟大的道德教师，但我不接受他自称为神。这是我们一定不能说的话。一个仅仅是凡人的人，即使说了耶稣说的那些话，也不会成为伟大的道德教师。他会是一个疯子，和说自己是个荷包蛋的人一个水平，否则他就是地狱的恶魔。你必须觉知，或者此人过去是，现在也是神的儿子，否则他就是疯子或者更糟糕的东西。你可以因为他是蠢人而让他闭嘴，你可以把他当作魔鬼唾弃或者杀死，或者你俯伏在他的脚下称他是主是神，但我们绝不能有那种他是个伟大的凡人老师之类的屈尊俯就的胡言乱语。他还没有允许我们这样说，他也没打算让我们这样说。
Okay, here is how C.S. Lewis says about Jesus. I am trying here to prevent anyone sayingthe really foolish thing that people often say about him. I'm ready to accept Jesus as a great moral teacher, but I don't accept his claim to be God. This is the one thing we must not say. A man who was merely a man and said the sort of things Jesus said would not be a great moral teacher. He would either be a lunatic on the level with the man who says he is a poached egg, or else,He would be the devil of hell. You must make your choice. Either this man was and is the son of God, or else a madman or something worse. You can shut him up for a fool. You can spit at him and kill him as a demon, or you can fall at his feet and call him Lord and God. But let us not come with any patronizing nonsense.Above his being a great human teacher. He has no left that open to us. He did not intend to.
耶稣基督就是那一位我是。
So Jesus Christ is that I am.
他是那位信实的且永活的神。
He is faithful and living.
他用大能的手。
He has mighty hand.
领我们出黑暗进入奇妙光明。
He can lead us out of darkness and into wonderful light.
所以我想回到一开始青城山的故事。
So I want to return to the beginning story about that mountain, 青城山。
来结束今天的讲道。
To conclude my sermon today.
今天我们敬拜的神是谁呢？
Who do we worship today? What God do we worship today?
他不是按照我们的想象被雕刻出来的。
He is not the one that was carved out according to our imagination.
他永远不是一个半成品。
He is not a half product.
他不是一块木头。
He is not a piece of wood.
我们敬拜他。
We worship him.
是根据他神圣的启示。
We worship him according to his sacred revelation.
他的教导，他的晓谕。
Sacred revelation and his teaching.
敬拜他根据他的所示。
And we worship him according to who he is.
而不是根据我们自己的想象。
Not according to our imagination.
我们一起祷告。
Let's pray.
亲爱的天父，我们感谢你的恩典。
Heavenly Father, we thank you for your grace.
我们是何等渺小、不配又无悔的罪人。
How unworthy and
渺小。
Meaningless we are.
主啊，但是你却向我们启示你自己。
But you revealed yourself to us.
你甚至差遣你的爱子耶稣基督。
And even send your beloved son Jesus Christ.
临到我们当中。
And come to us.
你向我们亲自启示你自己是谁。
And you reveal to us who you are.
以至于我们不需要去四处寻找。
So that we do not have to look around.
而是你寻找我们。
But you have found us.
你把我们找回。
And you found us and take us home.
你不仅领我们出黑暗，你还领我们进入光明。
Not only you lead us out of darkness, but also lead us into brightness, light.
你不仅与我们立约，你还实现你的约。
Not only that you made promise to us, but also you fulfilled your promise.
天父，这是何等令我们惊叹的救恩。
So this is how what amazing salvation this is.
主就恳求你帮助我们。
Lord, we ask you to help us.
每一天都活在你面前。
So we can live before you each of every day.
根据你向我们所启示的来敬拜。
According to what you have revealed us, we worship you.
帮助我们不偏离左右。
Help us not derail.
我们这样子的祷告。
We pray.
侍奉主耶稣基督的名求。
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.